So today I will talk about the last configuration of MOS amplifier. So in fact, in the last two classes, in the last few classes, we have talked about the two different types of configurations. More specifically, we have started with the common source MOS amplifier, and in the very last day, we have talked about the common drain type of MOS amplifier. So only one configuration is left, and that is the common gate type of MOS amplifier. So first of all, let me just show you the circuit diagram for a common gate MOS amplifier. Now, as you understand, for a common gate amplifier, the gate terminal is considered to be the common to both the input and the output. So here, the input is applied at the source end, and accordingly, the output is collected from the drain end. So let me just first of all draw the MOS device with three identified terminals: gate, drain, and source. So gate is common, so obviously there is no small signal applied at the gate terminal. Rather, we will be applying some fixed voltage at the gate terminal to operate the device in proper region. So this is the drain, this is the source terminal. So in the source terminal, the input signal is applied. So let this be like Vin, and there is a resistance which serves as the load resistance. So this is the drain supply, that is VDD, and the drain resistance RD is there, and we collect the output from this particular terminal, that is Vout, and there is a constant voltage at the gate terminal, that is VB. So this is the simplest configuration of a common gate type of MOS amplifier. So as I've already mentioned, for a common gate amplifier, the gate is considered to be common to both the input and the output. So whenever we will be drawing the corresponding small signal equivalent circuit, you will see that the potential, the AC potential at the gate terminal is zero. And accordingly, the input is applied at the source end, and the output is collected from the drain end. So let me call this MOS like M1. Now let us first try to understand what will be the scenario whenever the input voltage varies, and accordingly, what will be the corresponding variation in the output voltage. Now in this case, let's start from a different perspective. Let's start from a region where the input voltage is much, much larger. So we will be reducing the input voltage from a very high value, and let us see what happens. Now, first of all, you have to identify the different potential. So the drain potential is nothing but the V out, the source potential is nothing but the V in, and the gate potential is VB. So you have to identify the region of operation. So what about the gate to source voltage for this particular MOS amplifier? So VGS is nothing but the gate potential VB minus V in, the source potential. What about VDS? VDS is given by the drain potential V out minus the source potential V in. So these are the two potential, like VGS and VDS. And as you know, in order to operate the device in on condition, in order to operate the M1 as a closed switch, the gate to source potential must be higher than the threshold voltage. So therefore, whenever VB minus V in, that value is greater than the threshold voltage of the device, then M1 is on. Now, what is the condition in terms of V in? So if V in, so from this we can deduce that if V in is less than VB minus VTH, then M1 is on. So if I consider a very high value of Vin, say close to VDD or somewhat less than VDD, so then what happens? The corresponding value of Vin does not satisfy this condition. That means Vin is not less than VB minus VTH. And as a matter of fact, this MOS will be off. So when Vin is very large, if I consider very large value of Vin, very high value of Vin, then under this condition, this particular inequality is not satisfied because Vin is large with respect to VV minus VTH. And hence, the gate to source voltage is not higher than the threshold voltage and the MOS will be off. Now, if the MOS is off, and if I just neglect the sub-threshold conduction, so there will be no current flowing through this RD, that means the drain current is zero. And you can understand that the corresponding output voltage is equal to VDD. So V out will be VDD. So when V in is very large, so when V in is greater than VB minus VTH, then we can say that M1 is off. And accordingly, V out, the output voltage is equal to VDD. So that's why we have started discussing that particular topology by decreasing the value of Vin for a very large value. So when the input voltage is very large, then the MOS is off and V out is equal to VDD. Now, if I go on reducing the value of Vin, then a point will come when V is less than VB minus VTH, and then the device will become on. So the next question is that, what is the region of operation for the device? When it becomes on, whether it is on in saturation region or it is on in the linear or triad region. So we have to identify that point first. So for that, you know, if you have to compare this VGS and VDS, what you find is when VDS is greater than VGS minus VTH, then you understand that the device enters into the saturation region. So the drain to source voltage must be greater than gate to source voltage minus the threshold voltage. Now, if this condition gets satisfied, then the device enters into the saturation region. And then let us try to put the value over here. So what we find, V out minus V in, when this value is greater than VB minus V minus VTH, then we find that so Vin gets cancelled from both sides. So when V out is greater than VB minus VTH, then the device enters into the saturation region. Or in other words, what we can say is the source potential here is nothing but the input signal that we are applying over here. The source potential is input signal. And what about the drain potential? The drain potential is nothing but V out. So we can easily write down the expression for V out whenever some non-zero current is flowing. So we can always write down that equation like V out is equal to VDD minus RD into ID. So RD is the drain resistance and ID is the drain current that is flowing through the device. So whenever the inputs, whenever the MOS is becoming on, that means whenever the input voltage just goes below VB minus VTH, what about the value of V out? Then the V out is very large. When ID is equal to zero, the value of V out is equal to VDD. And whenever the input voltage goes below VB minus VTH, then V out just drops from VDD. Essentially, what we can say is the value of V out is closer to VDD whenever the device gets on. So obviously that value of VDD, that value of V out, which is pretty closer to VDD, this is obviously greater than VB minus VTH. That means we can say whenever the device becomes on, the value of V out is obviously greater than VB minus VTH. So therefore, and this is the condition to ensure that the device enters into the saturation region. So therefore, when the value of V in or the input voltage goes below VB minus VTH, the device becomes on in the saturation region. And if you go on increasing the value of V in, what happens? The device will move from the saturation region to the off condition. And on the other hand, if you go on reducing the value of V in, what happens? The corresponding value of V out also gets reduced. And a point will come when the device ultimately enters into the triode or linear region. Now that condition is established when, let me once again draw the circuit here. So this is the input voltage. So we are getting the output from this terminal. We have RT and this one is VDD. So V out can be represented by VDD minus RD into ID. And we have already seen that when some non-zero ID is flowing through the device, the value of V out goes below VDD. But obviously, since V out is greater than VB minus VTH, so therefore, the device becomes on in saturation. So M1 gets on in saturation region. In saturation region. And under this condition, we can easily write down the expression for the drain current. So the drain current expression will be half mu n C aux W by L. And you have to identify the gate to source voltage. So what is the gate to source voltage? VB minus V in. Gate potential minus the source potential minus the threshold voltage whole square. So right now I'm just neglecting the channel length modulation. In fact, I'll be incorporating the effect of the channel length modulation later on. Now for the simplicity, let us now forget about the channel length modulation. And this is the expression for the drain current. So half mu n C aux W by L into VB minus V in minus VTH whole square. And accordingly, we can write down the expression for V out as VDD minus half mu n C aux W by L VB minus V in minus VTH whole square into RT. Now, as long as the device is in the saturation region, then this condition must hold good. Now, what we are doing here, we are reducing the value of V in from a very large value. So when V in is very large, close to VDD, the device is off. And when the value of V in is less than VB minus VTH, then the device enters into the saturation region with an input-output relationship given by this particular expression. And then if I go on reducing V in further, then a point will come when the device enters into the into the triode or linear region. And that condition is satisfied when VGS minus VTH is equal to VDS. Or in other words, what we can write is VG minus VTH is equal to VD. So the value of VG is nothing but VB. So VB minus VTH, that is equal to VD. So what is the drain potential? That is nothing but the output potential, that is V out. So we can write like VDD minus half mu n C aux W by L VB minus V in minus VTH whole square into RT. Now this is the threshold value for V in. From that particular expression, you can easily find out the threshold value for V in. Now if you go on reducing V in further, what happens? This VGS minus VTH will be higher than VDS, and as a matter of fact, the device enters into the triode region. But as far as our understanding in MOS amplifier is concerned, we will definitely restrict our discussion of MOS device operating in the saturation region only. Because as you know, whenever the device enters into the triode region, the corresponding value of the mutual conductance drops drastically, and obviously we will be not getting the proper amplification. So once again, let me consider that particular expression, which is the equation we have to identify for the calculation of the gain for the common gate type of MOS amplifier. So this expression says that the output voltage is given by this VDD minus this RDID drop, the drop across the resistance RD. So from this large signal analysis, let me once again write down the expression. V out is given by VDD minus half mu n C aux W by L VB minus V in minus VTH whole square into RT. From this expression, we can find out the gain of the amplifier by differentiating V out partially with respect to V in. So if I follow the same process as we have done last time also. So this del V out by del V in, so VDD is constant. So obviously this will be zero. So you have minus sign over here, and then you have half mu n C aux W by L. Then this entire thing within the bracket is a function of the input voltage. So obviously, so x square, so you have to differentiate this x square with respect to x. It will be twice x. So there will be some, okay, let me just erase that part. So then you have 2 into VB minus V in minus VTH. And then you have to identify the dependence of these parameters with respect to V in. So obviously VB is constant, so we have provided some constant voltage which doesn't vary with V in. So obviously this variation is 0, and this one is minus 1, obviously del V in by del V in minus 1. Then what about the threshold voltage? Does it vary with the input voltage? So to give the answer of this question, once again you have to go back to the original circuit. So once again, if you can observe this circuit, here you find that the input voltage is nothing but the voltage applied at the source terminal. The body or substrate is grounded, but the source potential varies with respect to the input voltage. So therefore, if I just consider the VSV value, that means the source to bulk potential. So this VSV varies with respect to the input voltage. And therefore, we have to consider the impact of body effect. And whenever VSV varies, it is having the corresponding impact on the threshold voltage. So the threshold voltage is not constant. Rather, we have to find out the dependence of the threshold voltage with respect to the input voltage. del Vt is upon del Vin, and this entire thing is multiplied with Rt. Then what about V in? So as you can understand, V in is nothing but Vsb here, because the input voltage is applied at the source terminal. So therefore, V in is equal to Vsb. And already in some of the previous lectures, we have demonstrated that del Vt by del Vsb, that expression is nothing but eta. So considering this one, what we can write down over here is this del V out by del V in is nothing but the voltage gain AV. So half and two, so it gets cancelled. So we have mu n C aux W by L into VB minus V in minus VTH. And then this minus gets absorbed over here, and we have 1 plus eta multiplied with Rt. Now this entire thing, mu n C aux W by L into VGS minus VTH, as you understand, this entire thing is nothing but the mutual conductance of the transconductance of the device. So therefore, we can write this AV as GM times 1 plus eta times Rd. Or this is same as GM plus GMB times Rd. So this is the expression for the voltage gain. So what we can find is the value of the voltage gain is positive, unlike the common source amplifier. We have seen that for common source amplifier, the voltage gain is negative. That means there is a phase difference between the input and the output. But here, the voltage gain is positive, the amplitude is positive, and the value is pretty large depending upon the value of GM and GMB. And if I incorporate the impact of the body effect, it increases the corresponding transconductance. So if I do not incorporate the eta, it will be simply GM times Rt. But because of the incorporation of this eta term, the overall gain gets multiplied with 1 plus eta, and this is positive, and the value is moderate. The gain value is moderate, unlike the common drain amplifier, which we have discussed in the last class. We have seen that for a common drain amplifier, the value of the voltage gain is always limited to 1. It is always less than 1. But this kind of limitation is not there for a common gate type of MOS amplifier. So you can closely compare the performance, the behavior with that what we have studied in electronic circuits. You have seen that this common gate is very, very similar to common base kind of amplifier. You have seen that for common base amplifier, the voltage gain was positive. So there is no phase difference between the input and the output, unlike the common emitter amplifier. And on the other hand, if I consider the expression for the gain, for the common emitter and the common base, if I just consider the magnitude of the gain for common emitter and common base, they are comparable. So here also, if I consider the expression for the gain for the common source and the common gate, so they are also comparable. The only difference is that for a common source amplifier, the voltage gain is negative. That means there is a phase difference between the input and the output. And here, for a common gate amplifier, there is no phase difference between the input and the output. So the obvious question is that why should I study about this common gate amplifier? So as far as the voltage gain is concerned, you will find that almost equivalent or a comparable value of voltage gain you are getting. But the advantage lies in the form of the input and the output impedance. So we'll be discussing this issue later on. But before proceeding further, let me just try to incorporate the other effect while considering the expression for the voltage gain. So far we have only considered the body effect, that is this GMB times GM plus GMB times Rd. So body effect has been only considered, but there is another additional parameter which we have not considered, that is the output resistance R naught. So we have so far assumed that the R naught is very large, and since it is very large, so we can simply ignore the value of R naught. We can make it like an open circuit which is connected between the drain to source, but to be precise, you cannot neglect the value of R0. All that is very large, you cannot neglect. And moreover, we have not considered any source resistance associated with the input voltage. So considering these two elements, this RS, which is coming in series with this input voltage and the value of R0, we can once again recalculate the expression for the voltage gain. And that we will be doing using some small signal model. So first of all, let me draw the diagram once again, the circuit diagram. So here we will be considering a source resistance. And this one is V out. So V in is applied over here. Let this be RS, some non-zero source resistance we are considering, and this one is the gate potential, that is VB. Now what will be the corresponding small signal model? Let us try to identify the small signal model first. So one thing is very clear, that the gate is grounded. If I just consider the small signal model, the gate is grounded. There is no variation. It's a constant voltage VB over here. And suppose this drop is V1, and we have two voltage dependent current source. One is GM times V1, and second one is GMB times VBS. Now these two parameters we have already considered in the last explanation. Now, apart from that, we do have to incorporate the third element, that is R0, which is connected in between the drain and the source. So we are considering a finite output resistance, so that's why R0 is there. So this is the drain terminal. And ultimately, we do have some RD over here. And this one is output terminal, V out. Now, at the source end, we do have the resistance RS and the input V in. Now this is a small signal equivalent model for the amplifier which we have considered, and considering the effect of R0 and RS, we have to recalculate the expression for the voltage gain. That means the ratio between the Vout and the Vin. Now to do that, let me consider the current that is flowing through this RD is nothing but Vout upon RD, and the direction is from this terminal to this terminal, Vout upon RD. So the current that is flowing from this end to this end is nothing but minus V out by RT. And the same current is flowing through RS. So therefore, if I apply the Kirchhoff's voltage law between the gate and the source terminal, what we find is V1 minus V out by RD into RS plus V in is equal to zero. So here I'm assuming that the current will be flowing from this end to this end, and the magnitude of the current is nothing but V out upon RD, because the same current is flowing through the resistance RD and as well as through RS. The magnitude is V out upon RD. Now if it flows from this end to this end, so there will be voltage loss, and accordingly if I apply the Kirchhoff's voltage law KVL, we will find that V1 minus V out by RD times RS, that means the voltage drop across RS, plus V is equal to zero. So that is one part. And the second part is we have to find out the current that is flowing through the resistance R0. So what is the current that is flowing through the resistance R0? So if I call it like IR0, so the total current that is entering into this particular node is nothing but minus V out by RD, and out of that only two components are left out. So the current through R naught is given by minus V out by RD minus GM times V1 minus GMB times VBS. Now, if I simplify the expression for VBS, so VBS is nothing but VB minus VS, which is nothing but minus VS. So therefore, this expression ultimately will give you minus V1. So we can simplify the current through R naught like minus V out by RD minus GM plus GMB times V1. That is the current flowing through R naught. Now this current, while flows through R naught, there is a voltage drop across R naught. So that voltage drop can be calculated by finding out IR naught multiplied with R naught plus the drop across RS. And if I consider the input voltage together, and if I add on these three different voltages, that gives rise to V out. So what we can write is V out can be written like minus IR naught, rather it should not be minus, rather I am considering IR naught to be flowing in this direction. So this is the direction for IR naught. So it will be simply IR naught times R naught. So it is simply IR naught times R naught plus this drop across RS. That means, sorry, there is a double sign. Minus V out by RD into RS plus V in. So if I just put the value of IR naught over here, we will find that minus V out by RD now if I take it common outside, it will be plus GM plus GMB times V1 minus V out by RD into RS plus V in. Now to make it an equation of involving of only V in and V out, so I have to replace V1 by V out by RD into RS minus V in. Now with this, let me go to the next slide and let me write down the expression for V out. It was like we have a minus sign outside, and then V out by RD. Oh, I have missed one part. There is an R naught. There is an R naught multiplied with that. So minus V out by RT. So V out by RD plus we have gm plus gmb times v1. So instead of v1, what we can write is v out by adding into R is minus v in. Simple substitution. V out by RT into RS minus V in. So that gets multiplied with R naught minus we do have V out by RT into RS plus V in. So that is the final expression. Now from that expression, we have to ultimately find out the expression for the gain, and it suggests that so we will be taking V out in one side. So we have V out, so one plus we have this parameter, that is R naught by RD, and then we have plus gm plus gmb times rs r naught by rt plus rs by rt that is equal to so this one minus v in, so it will be plus, so we have v in multiplied with 1 plus, and then we have gm plus gmb minus minus, so plus gm plus gmb times R naught. So we have to simplify this expression. So in the numerator, let me just start with the denominator first. So RD in the denominator, and the numerator we have RD plus R naught plus GM plus GMB times RS into R naught plus RS. That is equal to V in multiplied with 1 plus gm plus gmb times R naught. So from that expression we can easily find out the expression for the gain, that is AV, which is nothing but V out by V in, considering the impact of both body effect and the channel length modulation. So what we find is it is nothing but 1 plus gm plus gmb times R naught obviously there is some RD here, and we have to simplify this expression. So in this expression we have RD plus R naught plus RS plus GM plus GMB times RS R naught. So this is the final expression considering the impact of both R naught and RS. And last time what you have seen is the expression was like GM plus GMB times RD, if I just forget about the impact of these elements. So that can also be obtained from this generic expression. So far in the last expression, in which case we have got like the expression of AV like GM plus GMB times RT, we have simply neglected any impact of R naught. we have assumed that R naught is pretty large, so it can be considered to be infinite. Now, if I consider R naught to be infinite, and if I just divide both the numerator and the denominator by R naught, then what we find in the numerator we have 1 upon R naught plus gm plus gmb, and the denominator we have 1 plus rs plus rd upon R naught plus gm plus gmb into rs R naught divided by, I think it will be better if I just show it mathematically. So that expression can also be written like 1 upon R naught plus gm plus gmb divided by one plus rs plus rd upon R naught plus gm plus gmb times rs into rd. Now, if I assume that R naught is pretty large, that means 1 upon R naught can be neglected. If I assume that R naught is infinite, which we have done in the last time, so then 1 by R naught can be neglected, so it will be 0. And this part also gets cancelled because rs plus rd upon R naught is also 0. And last time we have not considered any source resistance, so rs was 0. So ultimately we are left with gm plus gm in the numerator and 1 in the denominator. And obviously it is multiplied with rd. So this is the generic expression for the voltage gain, which involves both the mutual conductance gm and gmb and the R naught, which is the property of the transistor itself. And apart from that, we do have some external resistances like RS and RD. So this is the exact expression for the voltage gain for a common gate amplifier, common gate MOS amplifier. Now, as you understand, or if you can just compare the behavior of this common gate amplifier with that what we got in our electronic circuits discussion, that common gate is can be thought to be comparable to what we have got for common base amplifier. And here, if you can remember, for a common base amplifier, the input impedance of the amplifier is small and the output impedance is large. So these are the properties of associated with the common base amplifier. Now let us try to find out the expression for the input and the output impedance for a common gate amplifier as well. So let me just go to the next slide. And as you can understand, let me once again draw the circuit. And as you can understand, for a common gate amplifier, the input is applied at the source end. So this one is VDD, this one is RD, Vout, Vin, and this one is VB. So input is applied at the source end. So whenever we'll be talking about the input resistance or input impedance, so obviously we have to identify what is the impedance looking from this terminal, because this is the input terminal for a common gate amplifier. So that will be nothing but the Rin, the input resistance. Now to do that, what you need to accomplish is we have to draw the corresponding small signal equivalent model, and accordingly we can find out the expression for the Rin or the input resistance. Now, it's a very similar structure for the small signal model. So this is the gate terminal, and this one is the drain. So we do have two current sources, in form of GMV1 and GMV times VBS. And the resistance R0, which is connected in between the drain and the source. And here we'll be applying the input voltage Vin and suppose the current is Iin. And we have to show the drain resistance, which is connected in between the drain terminal and the VDD. So in the small signal model, the VDD is treated at AC ground. So this one is Vout. So ultimately, the input resistance Rin, which we want to calculate, is nothing but the ratio between these two, Vin upon Iin. So here, if you just, obviously I have missed one part, this one is V1, yeah. So one thing is very clear that V1 is equal to minus Vin, as apparent from this particular diagram. If I just neglect about RS, if I do not have any RS, if the source resistance is neglected, then V1 is equal to minus Vin. Then the current that is flowing through R0, we have to identify the current that is flowing through R0. So if I apply KCL, which is current at this particular node, that means at the source node, you will find that whatever the total current that is entering, the total current is Iin plus GMV1 plus GMVVBS. So if I assume that the current flowing through R0 is in this particular direction, so in this case, let us, for the sake of our analysis, let us assume that the current is flowing in this direction. And suppose this current is given by IR0. So then we can write IR0 is given by Iin plus GMV1 plus GMV VBS. Then what about VBS? So VBS is nothing but VB minus VS, since the subset potential is kept at ground, so therefore this is nothing but minus VS. And what about the source potential here? Minus VS means what? This is nothing but V1. And then you have to identify what about the Iin value. So the current that we are considering to be Iin, you have to identify that the same current is also flowing through the resistance RD. So ultimately, if this current is considered to be Iin, then what you can write is the voltage drop across the resistance RD plus the voltage drop across the resistance R0 is equal to the input voltage, that is Vin. So therefore, we can write RD times Iin plus R0 times IR0 is nothing but the input voltage Vin. So here we can just put the value of IR0 over here. So RD times Iin, because ultimately we have to express the entire thing in terms of Vin upon Iin. So plus R naught times I in plus GM plus GMB times V1 is equal to V in. And as you know, V1 is equal to minus V in. So therefore, what we can do is we can take I in one side. So I in into RD plus R0 is equal to V in into 1 plus GM plus GMB times R0. So from that we can easily find out the expression for R in, which is nothing but V in upon I in, and that is equal to 1 plus GM plus, sorry, I think made a mistake over here. Yes, so the final expression for R in, that is equal to V in upon I in, is nothing but RD plus R naught divided by 1 plus GM plus GMB times R naught. So since the value of GM and GMB is large in the saturation region because of the high current carrying capacity of the device, so the denominator is large. So the value of R in, the input resistance for this common gate amplifier, is small. So here we find that if I just neglect this one with respect to GM plus GMB times R0, so that can be approximated to RD plus R0 upon GM plus GMB times R0. So in case the current carrying capacity of the device is large, then the mutual conductance is also large. So therefore, GM plus GMB times R0 can be considered to be much, much larger as compared to 1. So I can approximate this expression to be RD plus R0 upon GM plus GMB times R0. So you do have R0 in both the numerator and denominator. So that can also be written like RD upon GM plus GMB times R0 plus 1 upon GM plus GMB. So I think there is a certain problem with the presentation here. Anyway, so I think we can understand this one, that the input resistance, looking at the source terminal for a common gate amplifier, is given by RD plus R0 upon GM plus GMB times R0. Now we will investigate this case from two different perspectives. The first perspective is that when the value of RD is equal to 0. So let us once again consider the input resistance Rin. So we have seen that that can be approximated to be like RD plus R0 divided by GM plus GMB times R0, if I just neglect this one term with respect to GM plus GMB R0. Now let us just try to understand this scenario from two different perspectives. The first case is that when RD is equal to 0. Now if RD is equal to 0, then you find that the input resistance Rin is nothing but 1 upon GM plus GMB. As simple as that. And you have already seen this expression in some previous discussion. Because to understand the notion of RD is equal to 0, let me just consider the circuit like this. So it is connected directly the supply. And we do have an input voltage applied over here. And we're taking the output from this terminal. So this one is Vin. So here Vin is the input voltage that is applied to the source terminal, and the current being drawn by the device, let it be IE. Then what about the resistance as seen by the signal source? The resistance provided by the signal source is obtained from the device itself. And if I consider the impact of the body effect, then the resistance is nothing but 1 upon GM plus GMB. So if RD is equal to 0, that means there is no resistance connected between the drain terminal and the drain supply, then the input resistance can be written like 1 upon GM plus GMB. On the other hand, if I just replace the resistance RT by means of a current source, and you understand that for any current source, for an ideal current source, the resistance is ideally infinite, and even for a practical current source, the corresponding resistance is pretty large. So if RT is being replaced by a current source, so let us try to implement RT by means of a current source, in which case you will find that the corresponding value of RD is much, much larger. So therefore, the Rin is also large. So RD is there in the numerator, and if it is replaced by a current source, so we are just considering two different scenario, two extreme condition. One condition when RD is very small, that is RD is equal to 0, that means it's a short circuit kind of thing. And the second case when the RD is very large, that means it is being replaced by a current source, then Rin is large. Then what we have discussed so far, that the input impedance provided by any common gate stage is small, can only be accomplished if the drain resistance is small. So I have just considered a scenario where the drain resistance is equal to 0, ideal short circuit, or suppose the value of the drain resistance is very small. On the other hand, if I would like to replace the RT, the drain resistance, by means of a current source, in which case you will find that the input resistance is no longer small, rather it is much, much larger, because RD is here in the numerator side. So if I replace RD by means of a current source, then Rin will be large. So in one sentence, we cannot always say that the input resistance provided by a common gate stage is always very, very small. This is only true when we are using a very small value of RD, or load resistance, in the configuration. If a current source is used to have the impact of a drain resistance, then obviously the input resistance is not at all small, rather it is very large. So after considering the input resistance, our next job is to find out the output resistance of this type of common gate amplifier. As you understand, for output resistance, so I think I need to draw the circuit once again. So this one is RD, this is VDD, there is some constant supply, this one is Vout, and this one is Vin. So for the output resistance, as you understand, so we have to observe the impact from this end. So this will give you the expression for Rout. So what is the voltage? So preferably we will be using a different voltage, like a Vx, some externally applied voltage Vx, and let us check what is the current being drawn by the circuit and the corresponding ratio between Vx and Ix will give you the value for the Rx or Rout. So for this particular case, let me just consider the small signal equivalent circuit with the gate is grounded. And we have two current source Gm times V1, where V1 is the voltage between these two, and Gmb times VBS. And then we have R0. And right now, if I just consider that R3 is very, very large, or it is being replaced by means of a current source, then the resistance RT can be neglected. Otherwise, whatever be the value of output resistance you are getting, you have to find out the final value of the output resistance with the aid of the parallel combination of this resistance and RD. Suppose we are just applying some external voltage like Vx and let the current being drawn by the circuit is equal to Ix. So as you understand, the R out is nothing but Vx upon Ix, because we have connected the external voltage at the output node. So output node here is the drain node. So you've connected the output, external voltage at the output node, the voltage equal to Vx, and the current being drawn by the circuit is Ix, and you have to accordingly find out the ratio between Vx upon Ix. And the source end, we have to complete the circuit diagram on the small signal model. So if you wish, you can also incorporate some non-zero source resistance over here, some RS, and the input voltage here. So R out, as you understand, is nothing but the ratio between Vx upon Ix. And what is the current that is flowing through R0? If I assume that the current is flowing in this direction, suppose the current is flowing in this direction, and that current is IR0, and then we can write IR0 is nothing but the current, that is total current is Ix, that is entering this node, minus these two, minus Gm times V1 minus Gmb times VBS. So that is equal to Ix minus Gm times V1, and whatever VBS is nothing but VB minus VS. That is equal to minus VS. So ultimately, what we can do is we can take this Gm plus Gmb together. Multiplied with V1. Right. Okay, so I'm just drawing the small signal model for calculating the output resistance. So obviously, this input should be absent, because while calculating the output resistance or output impedance, all the input signal which has been applied, that has to be made inactive. So this should be directly grounded, RS, because that is a normal practice. Whenever we calculate the output impedance, the practice is that we have to apply some external voltage at the output node, and we have to find out the current being drawn by the circuit. And while doing so, the input voltage has been made inactive. So obviously this should be grounded. So fully understand why Vin is grounded, because while calculating the output impedance, the input signal needs to be inactive. So the value of I or not, what we are getting here is nothing but Ix minus Gm plus Gmb times V1. Now, if the current is Ix that is flowing through these terminals, so obviously this current will be flowing through Rs. And we will find that V1 is given by minus Ix times Rs. So then that can be simplified to be Ix into 1 plus Gm plus Gmb times Rs. So then we have to find out the ratio between Vx and Ix, and in doing so we have to apply the KVL over here. So the voltage drop here is Vx between these two terminal, and here we have to equate this voltage with the voltage drop across R0 with the voltage drop across Rs. So these two voltage drop will be added together, and that is nothing but the value of Vx. So we can write Vx is nothing but I R0 multiplied with R0 plus Ix multiplied with Rs. So this one is Ix times 1 plus Gm plus Gmb into Rs into R0 plus Ix times Rs. So from that we can find out the expression for R out, which is nothing but the ratio between Vx and Ix. So if you do this calculation, you'll find that this is nothing but Rs plus 1 plus Gm plus Gmb into Rs. And the entire thing gets multiplied with R0. So that is the expression for R out. And you must appreciate that since this Gm plus Gmb itself is very large, and this is multiplied with R0, which is also very large, so the overall output impedance R out is much larger for this common gate amplifier. So the output resistance of the common gate amplifier is normally very large, because both Gm and Gmb, whenever the MOS is operating in the saturation region, both of them are large. And whenever it gets multiplied with R0, which is itself large, and therefore the value of R out is much, much larger as compared to its input impedance. And however, the value of the output resistance, so far we have just neglected the impact of RD. So as you understand, so while calculating this R out, we have considered that this is the boundary line between the drain and the ground. So the voltage that we are applying over here is the Vx, the external voltage we are applying, and the current being drawn by the circuit is Ix. So Vx upon Ix is nothing but the output resistance. Now while doing so, we have just neglected the impact of RD. We have assumed that RD is implemented by means of a current source, and for an ideal current source, our input resistance is, I mean, the resistance is very large. So we can just neglect. We can just consider to infinite, so we can just neglect the impact of RD. But in case we have to incorporate the effect of RD for some finite value of RD, so RD is also connected between the drain and the ground, because one end of RD is at the drain terminal, the other end is at the VDD, and VDD is at AC ground. So RD is also connected between this point and this point. So if you just neglect the impact of RD, so this will be the expression for R out. And if you do not neglect the impact of RD, if you just consider some finite value for RD, then the expression for R out can be written like the expression which I've already got, Rs plus R naught into 1 plus Gm plus Gmb times Rs. So that will be there. This entire thing will be there. And this entire expression will be in parallel with Rd. So because of a finite value of Rd, the overall output resistance will be somewhat reduced as compared to what we have got over here. So if I just neglect the impact of Rd, if I just assume that Rd is very large, is being implemented by means of a current source, then ideally the value is very large, R out. And if not, then we have to find out the exact expression for R out by incorporating the value of Rd. So since Rd is coming in shunt between these two terminal, so the final expression for R out will be nothing but this one. So we have just today considered the common gate amplifier, in which case the input signal is applied at the source terminal and the output is obtained at the drain terminal, and the gate terminal is considered to be the common terminal. That means gate is supplied with a constant voltage for the proper operation of the device, and we have calculated the expression for the voltage gain from two different perspectives. In one case, we have calculated the voltage gain from the current voltage relationship of the MOS amplifier from the large signal analysis. This expression we have considered, and the expression for Vout, and accordingly by calculating this del Vout upon del Vin, we have found out the expression for the voltage gain to be Gm plus Gmb times Rt. Now while doing so, we have neglected the impact of the body effect. No, we have considered the effect of body effect, but we have just neglected the impact of the channel length modulation, and we did not consider the effect of the source resistance of the signal source. So that we have added in the next calculation, in which case we have incorporated this R naught, that is nothing but the output resistance of the device, and also we have incorporated this Rs, that is the source resistance, non-zero source resistance, and accordingly we have recalculated the same thing using the small signal model, and ultimately we have found out the expression for the voltage gain. And we have also established that if in case when R naught is equal to infinite and Rs equal to zero, as was done in the last time, then we will be getting AP to be Gm plus Gmb times Rt. And then we have calculated the input resistance of the MOS amplifier, Rin, and the input resistance is obtained looking at the source end, because source is input terminal for a common gate amplifier, and we have gotten value for Rin, and it has been mentioned that the input resistance is small when you select a small value for load resistance. Otherwise, if you just consider a very high value of load resistance by implementing the load resistance by means of a current source, then the Rin will be pretty large. And then ultimately, in the last slide, we have just calculated the output impedance, the output resistance of the circuit, the common gate amplifier, and the output resistance of the circuit is obtained by providing some external voltage at the output node, that is at the drain node, and calculating the what is the current being drawn by the circuit. The same calculation which we have done many a times, and while doing so, we have to get rid of any external input voltage, because that particular thing, this Vin, so that's why Vin was grounded. I mean, so it was absent, and we have to calculate the ratio of Vx upon Ix, and that will give you the expression for R out or RO. And you can do that either considering an infinite value for Rd, just like a current source, or you can also consider a finite value for Rd. If I consider the finite value for Rd, then obviously the entire expression R out will be modified to some extent, and as has been shown over here. Now with this, I would like to conclude today's discussion on the common gate amplifier.